Hi, welcome to the first episode of Infinity and Beyond, a video series where we'll be covering actual rocket science, brought to you by Astronomy Magazine. Each week, we'll take a brief dive into a different cosmic topic, covering it from the basics to the latest research. My name is Abigail Bollenbach, and today I'll be taking you back to the very beginning, the Big Bang. The first suggestion of the Big Bang was in 1912. Later, in the 1930s, Hubble used the world's largest telescope and showed that the distant galaxies all appeared to be receding from us. That means that the farther away they are, the faster they're retracting. Then the first and most confident evidence we have came from 1964, when scientists at the Bell Labs discovered the cosmic microwave background radiation, confirming there was a Big Bang. This revolutionized cosmology, how we see the universe, and how we view our place within it. Now you might ask yourself, what was before the Big Bang? Scientists have come up with several possible speculations as to what existed, if anything at all. It's entirely possible that there was no previous era. Assuming this is true, it means that matter, energy, space, and time just began abruptly. So let's just start with the Big Bang itself. What happened immediately following with the explosions is called the Planck era, the earliest known meaningful time. According to the theories of physics, if we were to look at the universe 1 second after the Big Bang, there would be a 10 billion degree soup of neutrons, protons, electrons, positrons, photons, and neutrinos. Cosmic inflation creates a soup of subatomic particle plasma. It appears that this is what gave rise to dark matter, and likely the phase in which matter gained superiority over antimatter. Lucky us. Within the first 300 seconds of the existence of the universe, the elements hydrogen, helium, and some lithium form from the protons and neutrons. This process is called nucleosynthesis, and is a theory that accurately predicts the abundances of elements and isotopes found in the early samples of the universe, for example, in like some of the oldest stars. This verification is a strong indication that our model of the universe is accurate. 300,000 years later, when the nearly uniform soup cooled, atoms formed other nuclei. Photons ceased to scatter through space, turning the prior opaque universe into one with visible light. Those same photons, the actual afterglow of the Big Bang, known as cosmic background radiation, can still be observed today. To back up what I've just proclaimed, let's look at some more evidence. Space agencies have launched 3 missions to study this cosmic background radiation, taking baby pictures of the universe only 400,000 years after its birth. The first 2 probes mapped the primordial hot and cold spots in cosmic background radiation, measuring temperature differences that is nearly uniformly distributed across the universe. A third mission, with instruments sensitive to temperature variations of a few millionths of a degree, made the most accurate maps of the microwave background radiation yet. About 1 million years after the Big Bang, we enter a period called the Dark Ages, what's known as the final frontier of cosmology. Little is known about this period except the first stars and galaxies should have formed at about 100 million years. The limit of current observations, the oldest object that we can see, are at a time when the universe was only several hundred million years old. 2 future projects that have already begun construction are specifically designed to shed some light on this era and hopefully bring the Dark Ages to an end. Then fast forward to 10 billion years after the Big Bang, where dark energy, a mysterious force, starts to accelerate. Then we finally reach our time at 13.8 billion years after the Big Bang. Whew, that was a lot. I didn't know time travel could be so strenuous. Now, let's finish things up by briefly talking about how it will all end, the ultimate fate of the universe. It all hinges on dark energy. If the universe continues to grow at about the same pace, 30 billion years from now, all of the galaxies are pulled from our view, and all the evidence from the Big Bang is completely lost forever. This would result in all the last stars burning out in about 100 trillion years, so we've got plenty of time left, nothing to worry about. Dark energy could also intensify, resulting in a big rip scenario. This would happen in approximately 50 billion years from now, where dark energy effectively tears everything apart, from superclusters to atoms. If dark energy slowed down alternatively, this would give gravity the upper hand and lead to a collapse 30 billion years from now. What would be like a big crunch? If you're interested, you guys can catch the topic later on by continuing watching this video series. The nature of the universe is anything but simple. If we can take anything from this invaluable knowledge that we've managed to gather, it's that with science, we must continue marching onwards, because the universe sure isn't gonna slow down for us to catch up. And remember, there is no limit when you're watching Infinity and Beyond.